A man is earth, a man is seed carrier, a man is source. A man is not a title. A man is God's component. Okay. Everybody just went, oh, my grammar was wrong. Sex more than the woman.
True.
There's something he wants to give to the woman. The woman is not a seed carrier.
Can I break this down?
A man is earth. Break your Bibles down. This is where the teaching starts. Although we don't have time. And the Bible says in Genesis 2:18, and the Lord God said, it is not good that the man, the word man there, we all think it was referring to Adam. The word man that was referring to everything God has created came down to one full stop, and if that full stop was not there, creation would have been a mess. The beast of the land, the best of the air, the fish, the birds of the air, the fish of the sea, with that man, they would have been there for nothing. God needed man, a company. Different things makes up a man. Not your muscle, or how deep your voice is, or how tall you become, or how old you become. You can be 50 years old and be a boy, and you can be 14, but you're a man. It is not good for a man to be what?
No.
Now, before I go down with that teaching, that word man, what is the source of man itself? You sure? It's not dust. No?
Wisdom.
No? No. What is the source of man?
God.
Of course, God is the source of everything, but what is the source of man? Come on, you guys are getting to make answer. If we become precise with our answers, the devil is going to have a chance for the church.
God's first creator.
Sorry?
God's first creator.
God's first creature. You're there, but you need to go back. Go, before you get to the image of God, what is the there is something for the image. What is the source of man? You're saying the answer, but you need to give me the answer. No. Raise your hand up. Father, grace, you must pledge one.
Amen.
The source of man is the word. Let us what? Before God creates mouth, actions. God created the heavens and the earth, Genesis 1:1. Past tense. If you see, Genesis 1:1 says, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. Past tense. But verse 3 says, and then God said, let there be light. But I think he has finished in verse 1. In his mind he finished. is words, action is mind. The source of man is his word. That's why any man disconnected from the word of God will miss it for life. And any woman connected to a man not connected to word, to the word, will end up in his beat. A man must be connected to the word for him to live life. In the word, Genesis 1, was life. And that life, the light. Like unto man. And the light shineth in darkness. For your man to be a superstar, he must be deep, deep down in the world. The word of God is the source of man. Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. Genesis 1, 26. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion. See this? Let us, a spoken word. Without God saying, let us create man, let's make man, man will not be made. Watch this. It was never God's plan to make the woman. It was not on God's itinerary to create a woman. It was after God had created the man, he realized, oh, man is actually alone. Then he said, it's not good. So, the woman was sent to stop man from being alone. That's the first thing.
Hallelujah.
And this is saying, every man created by God has a void in it that the right woman will fill.
Amen.
If you get the wrong woman, you compound the problem. It's like putting a square key in a round hole. Or a square hole. A round key in a square hole. Am I talking to someone?
Yes.
Let us bring man in our own image and likeness. That's where image now comes in, and likeness. Those are the components. What is image? What is likeness? Similar, but it's different. What's image? What's likeness? Image, representation of the external form of a thing. Likeness, the fact or quality of being like the thing. That is to say, image is I look like you. Likeness is I carry what you carry. So the man looks like God in church. Hey, Father in heaven, I will love you. In him, no God. A lot of women are impressed with the man's suit and shoe. He comes to church on Sunday. And then I say, oh, sister Faith, woman, how you doing? Okay, you're looking good. God bless you, looking good. Amen. Let's lift up our hands to the Lord this morning. Praise God. But yet you've not tested the validity of his praise, God, in it.
Yes.
I know people. You meet them, man. Before you say yes or consider, give him 6 months. You will know. Not 2 years. If the man has been with you more than 1 year, no ring on the finger, wrong. It's a time waster. You meet your wife, 6 months is okay for you to know. Move on. What's your time? It's 5. You know, we've been around 5 years. He's put the ring on it. 5 years, the ring on it. He has not married you, but he engaged you. He's tied your destiny. He's a destiny killer. If you keep him in prison, your mate will have 3 children, you are still wearing. He's put the ring on it, 10 years. Then after 15 years, he will just see one girl from nowhere and marry her in 2 days. And you tell him, but I gave my life, I'm waiting for you. You were waiting for him, he wasn't waiting for you. Hey. Let us make man in our image. Likeness. Number one that ladies need to know, when you meet a man, the first thing you need to find out is if you see the image of God in him and he carries God's likeness. What am I trying to say? When a man carries the likeness of God, the Holy Spirit is a perfume. You know. Do you want me to tell you how you will know if your man will love you very well? Watch his relationship. Watch the man's personal relationship. When the man starts backsliding from God, he will fall into sin easily. But when he's trying to stay, he's pressing my grace in that relationship, no matter what he faces, he will still stand there. A man's relationship with God replicates into his marriage, into the way he will love you. After spending time in God's presence, the next person wants to spend time with you. If he spends time away from God's presence, he will spend time away from you. So you must make sure he's there. That's why you don't like it. Because after the man spends time in God's presence and is alone, loneliness is what? The workshop of the devil. Let me bring the woman, and God gave man the woman. It's not for him to be alone before he turns to the workshop of the devil. Now, when the woman was lonely, what happened to God? That is where the man's responsibility comes. You instill yourself in her that when you're not there, she still carries you. Because why? The man, God has instilled himself in us, and when we don't see him, we carry him through his spirit. Your wife is meant to carry your spirit. That's why you are comfortable. Whatever God has replicated into you, you need to replicate it to your wife. That's why the greatest achievement as a man is the day your wife sees you as a pastor. And I say, the greatest achievement of a man is the day your wife sees you and recognizes you as her own pastor. She will never come to you for coming any so-called man of God. Even if you don't serve. You must strive to be your wife's pastor. It's not by mouth, by grammar, by power, by force. It's by the evidence of the move of God in you. She sees it. When I first called myself pastor, she said, "You pastor, God called you. God, he called me. Let me go to my banking." I only became a mass pastor 3 years ago. Two years ago. She doesn't see me as pastor before. She knows me as Oni. Oni finish. But now, pastor. And there was a month ago I was sleeping. She woke me up 2:30 a.m. I want a prophecy. I'm sleeping. Are you not a prophet? People will call the phone and say there's an emergency, you will jump. So me, your wife, I can't get. Oh, but the sleep just cleared. I said, so what do you want God to do for you? She said, not yet. The children are sleeping. You have to go to the sitting room. Hey, see me dragging myself in the Bible. The Bible became very heavy. Before I said 1, 2, she was on her knees. What do you want God to do for you? She said, no, we're not praying like this. You have to clear your eyes. And she stood up on the brain tea. I drank. She waited until my eyes was sharp. So what do you want the Lord to do for you? Before she said 1, I said, stop. I started telling her things of her family. Her friends I never met before. I told her, she was like this. How did you know? She said, hey, 2:30 tomorrow. I want the prophecy. I said, you try it. Wake me up. I lock myself in the toilet. Praise God. Your woman was seen as a pastor. For God is the covering over Christ, and Christ the covering over the man, and the man the covering over the woman. The error in the church is that women don't see Christ in the man, and they go bypassing the man to God, and the man feels like a nobody. Let me tell you, that is why many women's prayers are not being answered, because there's a spiritual formula for you to get answers in the spirit. You cannot bypass the man and get to God. You cannot bypass Jesus. Jesus, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man get to the Father except they go through me. Same with the man. If the man is your covering, you must go through him to God. Through him in agreement. We are having this error. Push the man aside. Let me tell you something. The only time you can bypass your man and go to God in prayer is two ways. If you have reported your man to his mentor or pastor, the man your husband is accountable to, if you have reported him to that man and your husband refused to adhere to it, then you go to the father. You report him. The other time you can bypass your husband is by praying for him.
Amen.
As a woman, or putting him in prayer. But you feel you can just go pray, God pray, and just intake. There is who? Where? Adam, where are you? Man, where are you? Where are you, man?